Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel at Cute Little Things with Nancy. Very looking forward to spring this year. And I thought I would start it off with this Butterick pattern right here. Originally when I saw this, I wanted to do letter A, but after picking my fabric, I went ahead with B. And we'll be working on pattern B6761. I went ahead and cut all my pieces and I numbered them, that way I know which one's which. And when I saw this pattern, I fell in love because it gave me plant lady vibes. And let's get started. I'd mark my back pieces and you're going to stitch where the darts are facing to the center on both sides. What I like to do is fold it in half as much as I can. That way it's matching my lines that I have made. And then I clip, or you could pin if you have pins. That way it stays still. Or you could also iron it so you get a nice crisp edge. And just go ahead and sew where the line is marked, and then you could iron, press iron, or just with your finger press really hard. That way your flap is facing the center on both of your pieces.
Grabbing your bias tape, you then want to gently unfold one side, and with your fingers press it open. You then want to apply it right on top of your stay stitch, and you can clip or pin all the way around, and then add another stitch right on top to hold the bias tape in place. You're then going to want to fold your bias tape right in half over your trim piece and covering your first stitch. And just take your time, that way it's even on both sides. Once you have completed that all the way around, go ahead and sew a top stitch right at the edge. There's different ways you can sew your edges together with your bias tape, but what I ended up doing was just cutting my tail short and folding one piece right on top of the other. Just be mindful on which side you stitch your piece number 9 to 10. The way I did it gives me a left side slit. If you do the other side, it'll give you a right side slit, just the way it is shown on the pattern's picture.